Albion's taken over the whole station.
And the entire police service. But don't worry, if you're not pleased with your privatized goon squad, just take your business across the street.
Not a fan of cops, but I'll take them over rent-a-soldiers.
Not to worry, the only difference now is the uniform, assault weapons, and the fact they're motivated by profit over public service. Now, any record or information on the Spider-Bot will be further in. Get to him quickly.
Is that our favorite Spider-Bot?
According to the serial numbers, this matches the piece of Spider-Bot from the Tone bombing site.
Don't suppose you could identify the last user?
Navigate the Spider-Bot from out of that room. I'll need a direct connection in order to learn more from our bisected friend.
Fine, I'm on it. Let's make things interesting. Let's shut things down.
piece of junk.
Turn around.
Cease and desist, or you will be restrained.
Live alarm. Location send.
Suspect is open fire.
Got a drone on my ass.
better. That opening right there looks like a good exit point. Right, get comfy. This spiderbot might be broken and missing some of its legs, but it can still jump and fit through vents. That's a good way to get through the station undetected. Buckwood, you look at all this junk. You'll have to jump your way across to get to the next vent opening. Almost there. Make your way through this last vent path. Scanning Spiderbot and accessing its internal drives. While I'm analysing this data, you should make yourself scarce, unless you'd like to explain to your new, heavily armed, privatised police force why you've broken into the station.
Fine.
The Spiderbot fragment you found had a satellite-based GPS module that regularly pushed its location to a specific ground station.
Secret location? Sounds like another breadcrumb on the trail. I say we go deeper into the woods.
Pushing you the ground station's coordinates.
That's exactly what I said. You just gotta call him.